Well, our next performer is a native Brooklynite. He's a rookie at the tournament, but a veteran singer and Savoyard with many years of stage and choral experience, Ken Seims.
It's true. The clown has made it clear. The climate must be perfect all year. A law was made a distant year ago here. July and August cannot be too hot. And there's a legal limit to the snow here in Camelot. The winter is forbidden till December, and exits March the 2nd on the dot. By order, summer lingers through September in Camelot. Camelot, Camelot, I know it sounds a bit bizarre, but in Camelot, Camelot, that's how conditions are. The rain may never fall till after sundown. By 8, the morning stars must disappear. In short, there's simply not a more congenial spot for happy ever aftering than here in Camelot. On the dot. By order, summer lingers through September in Camelot. Camelot, Camelot, I know it gives a person pause, but in Camelot, Camelot, those are the legal laws. Slush upon the hillside. By 9 p.m. the moonlight must appear. In short, there's simply not a more congenial spot for happy ever aftering than here in
Times, accompanied by Jon Delfin on the piano. Our next performer describes his occupation as monkey doctor, broadcaster, frog counter, and utility violinist. 30-some years ago, as a college drop-in, he founded one of the top 10 university juggling clubs in the Big Ten. And performed regularly with the Anti-Gravity League. This is Dan Sadoff.
My name's Dan, I'm a liar. been on us for about 10 minutes. That is about par for the course, but we'll talk about that some more in a moment. I told Will I'm a juggler. And, you know, that wasn't completely untrue, what I said to get on this stage. Or what he said in his intro. Every bit of that is pretty much true, or at the very least, truthy. But the fact is, I have Fiona beat. In the past 25 years, I think this is the third time I've juggled in front of people. So I guess that qualifies me as a recovering juggler. But here's the dirty secret of juggling. It's not that tough. You don't even need to be able to throw and catch a ball. All you need is more objects than you have hands to hold them. You don't need two hands.
Oh, this lighting's great.
Yeah, I know, you've seen that before. So I'm going to do a few tricks, and I'm going to talk about lies and lying liars, to quote my junior senator. Yes, I am from Minnesota. Oh, thanks, Mom. I'll be right back to that, but let's try a trick first. I'm not talking about dirty lies. I'm not talking about terrible things people put in tabloids about famous people or on blogs. I'm not talking about swindling investors out of billions of dollars. And I'm sorry if that hits a little too home in New York, but a little too close to home. I'm talking about the things that get you through the day, and especially through work. Not too long ago, someone said to me that good relationships depend on basic acting skills. But what are basic acting skills except good, convincing, relaxed lies? But we'll talk about work in just a second. Let me try another trick. You know, if the ball hits the ground, don't worry about it. I'm not going to chase anything. But I won't subject you to more than two tries, except maybe at the very end. That'll be all. This is a clicker counter. Try an experiment at work. Get one of these, or there's probably a phone app for it, whatever that is. When you're at work, have one of these in your pocket. You want to be discreet about it, you know, so it really helps if you wear a lab coat at work. Every time you say something that isn't totally true, just click it and see what it says at the end of the day. You might be surprised, or depending on the kind of work you do, you might not be surprised at all. This one only has four digits in it. You may need to get the deluxe model. I don't even have to say what kind of work might need that. But, for example, it starts in the morning. Great to see you. So glad we had this meeting. Of course I can do that and have it to you by the end of the day. Sure, I've done it before. And don't forget, no problem. Not a problem at all. No problem. You know, if you don't say you can do something, or if you answer truthfully to any of those things, you're either not going to have a job, or you're sure not going to ever get a raise again. Let's try another trick.
Oh, let's see.
The most pleasurable. Really, I'm here, like I said, to talk a little more about lying. I did some research for this, You know, I'm sorry. I wanted to juggle while I was talking, but it's just a little too hard to be up front here in a fixed mic. Of course, I started my research by looking for synonyms, being a word nerd like I am. You know, I know logophile is a more proper word, but it sounds too dirty to me. So I started at work, of course. I started with Microsoft Office thesaurus, if you'll pardon the expression, and came up with the various words for, you know, lying. You can, you know, certainly you can deceive, you can perjure, you can dissemble, you can tell an untruth, a fib, a falsehood. You can perpetrate a charade, give me a moment. You can come up with an inoperative statement, to use a nice bureaucratic term. It's not going to be too long. Propaganda, of course. Then when it gets down to other words for liars, you know, the Microsoft thesaurus doesn't mince words. I'm a fraud, a cheat, a swindler, an imposter, a quack, a phony, a fake. But then when you get to the synonyms for truth, it's fact, uprightness, legitimacy, honesty, integrity, please, sincerity. Is it just me? Or is this software product being judgmental? You know, it was supposedly created by aging hippies. Let's try another trick.
That's not it. That is.
Thanks. But of course, my favorite thesaurus is my 1940 edition. You know, and I'm sure other people share my sentiments. They devote a full 3 pages of that tiny thesaurus print under those obscure numerical categories to the language of falsity. And this is the best part of it. I'm sure, I don't know if anybody has looked in those particular 3 pages or not, but you don't just lie. You can cluck, diddle, sniggle, give the go by, draw a herring across the trail. I can't come close to giving you a full list. These are just some of my favorites. You can tell the full range of falsehoods, from a taradiddle, of course that shows up in crosswords all the time, to a traveler's tale, to a Cornish hug. That's the mildest of the ethnic slurs in those 3 pages. They offend every nationality on the face of the planet, including a number who don't exist. And I know we have some British friends here, and truly, I didn't mean to offend them. Just a second. But really, my favorite words in the thesaurus under lying and falsity come under the heading of liars, because I'm no simple liar anymore. I found the words, of course, mountebank, peck sniff, saltimbanco, maw worm? Never heard of it. But my favorite in there, juggler. So I was so glad to find that, because it means I didn't lie to Will in the first place after all. Let's try one more trick, and you're going to have to give me 3 tries on this, because it's the hardest.
Oh, so close. Nope, going to do it.
It's one more.
One more, and then you get the idea.